We live happily during the war. And when they bombed other people's houses, we protested, but not enough. We opposed them, but not enough. I was in my bed. Around my bed, America was fallen. Invisible house. By invisible house, by invisible house, I took a chair outside and watched the sun. In 6 months of a disastrous rain, in a house of money, in a street of money, in a city of money, in a country of money, our great country of money, we forgive us, lived happily during the war. Gunshot. Our country is a stage. When soldiers march into town, public assemblies are officially prohibited. But today, neighbors flock to the piano music from Sonia and Alfonso's puppet show in Central Square. Some of us have climbed up into trees. Others hide behind benches and telegraph posts. When Petya, the deaf boy in a front row, sneezes, the sergeant puppet collapses, shrieking. He stands up again, snorts, shakes his fist at the laughing audience. The army jeep swerves into the square, disgorging his own sergeant. Disperse immediately! Disperse immediately, the puppet mimics in a wooden falsetto. Everyone freezes except Petya, who keeps giggling. Someone claps a hand over his mouth. The surgeon turns toward the boy, raising his finger. You! You, the puppet raises a finger. Sonia watches her puppet. The puppet watches the surgeon. The surgeon watches Sonia and Alfonso. But the last of us watch Petya lean back, gather all the speed in his rod, and launch it as a sergeant. The sound we do not hear lifts the cows of the border. Darkness and insurgency begins. Our country woke up next morning and refused to hear soldiers. In the name of Petya, we refuse. At 6 a.m., when soldiers compliment the girls in the alleyway, the girls slide by, pointing to their ears. At 8, the bakery door is shut on soldiers Ivanov's face, though he's the best customer. At 10, Mama Galia chokes, no one hears you, at the gates of the soldiers' barracks. By 11 a.m., arrests begin. Our hearing does not weaken, but something silent in us strengthens. After curfew, families of the arrested hung homemade puppets out of their windows. The streets empty, but for the squeaks of strings and the tap, tap against the buildings of wooden fists and feet. In the ears of the town, snow falls. Alfonso stands answerable. My people, you are really something fucking fun on the morning of the first arrest. Our men, once frightened, bound to the beds, now stand up like human masks. Daphne passes through us like a police whistle. Here as an eye testify, each of us comes home, shuts at a wall, at a stove, at a refrigerator, at himself. Forgive me, I wasn't honest with you. Life, to you I stand answerable. I run, etc. With my locks and my hands, etc. I run down Vassenka Street, etc. Whoever listens, thank you for the father and my tongue. Thank you for our arguments that end. Thank you for deafness, Lord, such fire from a match you never lived before the war, we made a child. I kissed a woman whose freckles are lost the neighbors. She had a mole on her shoulder, which she displayed like a medal for bravery. Her trembling lips, men come to bat. Her hair, water falling in the middle of the conversation, men come to bat. I walked in my barber shop of thoughts, yes. I divvied her off to bed on the chair of my hairy arms, but parted lips, but bite my parted lips, lying under the cool sheet, Sonia, the things we did. While the child sleeps, Sonia undresses. She scrubs me until I spit soapy water, peek, she smiles. A man should smell better than his country. Such is the silence of a woman who speaks again, silence known that silence is what moves us to speak. She throws my shoes and glasses in the air. I'm of deaf people and I have no country but a bus stop and an infant and a marriage bed soaping together. That is sacred to us, washing each other's shoulders. You can fuck anyone, but with whom can you sit in water? In a time of peace, inhabitant of earth, for 40-something years, I once found myself in a peaceful country. I watched neighbors open their phones to watch a cop demanding a man's driver license. When the man reaches for his wallet, the cop shoots. Into the car window shoots. It is a peaceful country. We pocket our phones and go to the dentist to pick up the kids from school, to buy shampoo and basil. Ours is a country in which a boy shot by police lies on a pavement for hours. We see in his open mouth the nakedness of the whole nation. We watch others watch. The body of a boy lies on a pavement exactly like the body of a boy. It is a peaceful country, and it clips our citizens' bodies effortlessly, the way the president's wife trims her toenails. All of us still have to do the hard work of dentist appointments, of remembering to make a summer salad, basil, tomatoes, it is a joy, tomatoes, and a little salt. This is a time of peace. I do not hear gunshots, but watch birds splash over the backyards of the suburbs. How bright is the sky as the avenue spins on its axis. How bright is the sky? Forgive me. How bright? Thank you.